Greetings, Stargazers. I'm James Albury, director of the Kika Silva Pla Planetarium in Gainesville, Florida.
And I'm Dean Regas, astronomer for the Cincinnati Observatory, and we're here to help you find your way around the sky. Hey, James, it's almost the end of the year. Did you have an astronomically great 2017?
I did. We had so many planetary conjunctions and, of course, the total solar eclipse back in August.
It was an awesome year. And for our last week of 2017, we'll take a look at the constellation Orion and a special visitor he will be having on New Year's Eve.
Oh, that's right. Our closest neighbor in space, the moon, will pass just over Orion's head. He better duck.
You know it. Let's show you. Okay, we have our sky set up for Friday, December 29th at 7:30 p.m. facing east-southeast. There you'll find the belted one, Orion the Hunter, tipped over just above the treetops.
You can always recognize Orion by his three stars in a row that make his belt. But I always like to find the four stars at the corners of this star pattern. The brightest star in Orion is Blue Rigel, which stands for his left leg. His right leg star is the fainter and closer to the horizon. Its name is Safe.
Then, his left shoulder star is a deep blue color and goes by the name Bellatrix, while the big red star marking Orion's armpit is the infamous Betelgeuse. We'll try not to say it three times.
Where's my head?
What?
I almost forgot about the star marking Orion's head.
Oh, yeah.
Its name is Musa, and unlike Dean and I, it's not very bright.
Yeah, Orion was known for his brawn and not so much for his brains, and his head star really shows that.
On December 29th, the moon is way above Orion and is hanging out in the constellation Taurus the Bull. But before we go forward in time, let's fly up and see how the moon moves around the Earth. The moon revolves around the Earth once every 27.3 days. That's called a sidereal month.
Can we call it a month?
A month? What's that?
Well, it's like a month, but for the moon. What do you think? Catchy? Not too catchy?
Eh.
Anyway, over the course of a month, the Earth is rotating once every day. That means we spin way faster than the moon. So after every day that we spin once and come back to see the stars again, the moon has moved a little bit around us. So it looks like it has shifted in our sky.
So each night the moon will be near a different group of stars and can even wander near Orion's head over the course of a month.
Yes. Okay, we're back down on Earth at 7:30 p.m. on December 29th. Now we're going to advance our time one day at a time and see how things move. On the night of the 30th, the moon has continued on its path around the Earth and has appeared to shift quite a bit in the sky. The moon will now be right next to the bright orange star called Aldebaran that marks the bull's eye.
If you look at the moon through binoculars that night, you'll see Aldebaran is less than half a degree from the moon. That's super close.
But that's nothing. If we use our super stargazer powers to turn back time to like 6 p.m., and then slowly advance time, check out what the moon will do.
It will occult or cover over Aldebaran. Sweet.
Now, this will be visible over most of the US, but not everywhere. So you'll have to just get outside and see for yourself how close the moon passes Aldebaran, where you live on December 30th.
Let's advance time again to 7:30 p.m. on Sunday, December 31st, New Year's Eve. On that night, the nearly full moon will hang just above Orion's head. Look, did he duck?
No, James, that's how he always is. The moon can appear to come close to Orion's head, but can never quite cover over his head star, Misa, or bonk him on the head. But on New Year's Eve, maybe you can imagine Orion hitting the moon with his club.
I can see that. So, check out the moon as it moves closer to Orion all week.
And on December 31st, be like Orion and
keep looking up.